Hello friends, welcome back to the channel. In this video we will see how to make a rectangular box from sheet metal in a workshop, right? So let's see. So this is the object that we are going to make in a workshop, right? So length of the object is 110 mm and width of the object is 80 mm and height of the object is 30 mm, and these two sides are joined with the help of rivet joint as well as spot welding, and the material of the object is GI sheet. You can make this kind of object from any sheet metal. Okay, so since the length of the object is 110 mm and height of the object is 30 mm right on both the sides, so total length that we required for making this object is 110 plus 30 plus 30, so 110 plus 60, that is 170 mm, right? Similar way, the total width is 80 mm plus height 30 plus height 30, so 80 plus 30, 110 plus 30, 140. So total width we required is 140. So the final dimension of the sheet for making this object is 170 length, 140 width. Okay, so for making this object we will select a slightly higher dimension than this, and we will take 180 by 150 metal sheet, and from that we will remove the excess material to get our exact dimension, right? So let's say we will cut it out, this 180 mm by 150 mm metal sheet from the metal with the help of tri-square and scriber. Scriber is used for generally marking purpose on the sheet or on the material, on the metal specifically. And this tri-square is usually used for checking the perpendicularity between the two surfaces or two edges or two line. Okay, so with the help of this tri-square and scriber, draw one reference line over here. So this is, let's say, the first reference line, and perpendicular to that reference line draw the another reference line over here with the help of this tri-square. And for making this marking or making this marking line on the metal sheet, we will use this scriber. Now from this reference line, now select the exact dimension that we required as a width, let's say that is 140 mm. So with the help of steel rule, select this from this reference line, draw another reference line which is at a distance of 140 mm from this reference line, and similar way from this reference line draw another reference line at a distance of 170 mm. So this is the final dimension of the object that we required for making our object. Now we will remove this excess material using the straight snip. Now the height of the object is 30 mm, so we will mark the 30 mm line over this using the scriber again on this lengthwise direction. So mark 30 mm on this lengthwise direction. So let's say this is 30 mm. So with the you can measure this with the help of steel rule, right? Similar way, mark 30 mm on this side. So this two side will be bent and it will act as a height of the object. Similar way, mark 30 mm over the width wise. So this is, let's say, 30 mm over the width wise, and similar way 30 mm over the width wise. Now with the help of straight snip, cut out this material up to the 30 mm only. So up till now we have seen how to use a scriber, tri-square, a steel rule and straight snip to remove this excess material. Now the next part of the operation are bending and check perpendicularity, riveting and spot welding. Let's see how to do that. So this is our tinsmithian plumbing shop, and he is Sri KP Katara sir, lab in charge of Tin Smithy shop. This is a tri square which is used for checking two perpendicular surfaces. This is a scriber, as discussed in previous part of the videos. Scriber is used for marking purpose on the metal sheet, like this way, right? Then this is a straight snip used to cut the metal. That is hammer. With the help of support block and bench vise, the workpiece is mounted on the bench vise with the help of support block, and with the help of this hammer and angle, we can make it bend. We can bend this surface at exact 90 degree. Now that this is rivet, so rivet is generally used for joining the two surfaces or two side of this workpiece. A rivet joint is a permanent joint. Now let's start the first operation, that is marking. So as discussed in previous part of video, we first cut out the material about 180 by 150 mm. So with the help of this steel rule and the scriber, mark this length 150 by 180 mm and cut out that section. Now here you can see the marking. Now with the help of straight snip, cut out that section of the material. Now with the help of this tri square, make one reference line on that on the sheet, and with the help of this tri square make another reference line which is perpendicular to that sheet. Now we have two reference line. Now with the help of these two reference line, mark the exact dimension of, let's say, 170 mm lengthwise and 140 mm widthwise. So you can see the marking on the metal sheet over here. Now see, height of the our rectangular box is 30 mm, right? So we have to mark 30 mm from all the four side of the object, all the four side of the boundary of the object. So for that we are marking the 30 mm along the length side and 30 mm along the width side, as we have discussed in the previous part of the video. Similar with 30 mm on width. You can see the marking clearly over here. So after marking on the metal sheet, you will have this kind of sheet where every corner have a 30 by 30 square, right? Every corner of the sheet, there will be a 30 mm by 30 mm square will be there. Now with the help of straight snip, remove all the excess material. So first we are removing the excess material from the boundary. So this is the final object after marking or after removing the excess material. Now we have to cut it 30 mm lengthwise so that we will bend this side of the object, like as so. Just cut 30 mm into the sheet on all the four sides. Now this two side will be bent to make this height of the rectangular box. Now let's say this is our side A, this is our side B, side C and side D. So first we will bend side A. So take with the help of this support block, fix that side and arrange the support block in such a way that the edge of the support block and the our marking line will coincide, and fix that in that position into the bench wise. If the position is not correct, with the help of hammer, little hammer bro, if the position is not correct, with the help of little hammer bro, make it correct, and after correcting it, fix the bench wise so that it won't So first bend it with manually with your bare hand, and now with the help of this angle and hammer, bend this side exactly 90 degree this way. And check the perpendicularity between these two surfaces with the help of tri-square. Now same operation for the second side, let's say side B. First the make sure that the marking line and this edge of the support blocks are exactly coincide. And once it is coincide, first bend it manually. So once the position is okay, then fix the bench wise and bend it manually. So first bend it manually, now with the help of this angle and hammer, make the second side bend like this, bend this second side like this. Again check for the perpendicularity between these two surfaces with the help of tri-square. Now let's say third side of the object, side C. Same operation should be repeated for this side C. Again check for the perpendicularity between these two surfaces. Now remove the sharp corner of the corner edges, so that is chamfering. Removing the sharp corner, so that operation is known as chamfering. Again, first bend it manually, now with the help of angle. Now these two sides will be joined using riveted join, and other two sides will be joined using spot welding. The third, fourth side, for fourth side we required a smaller support block. While doing this operation, make sure those sharp corners are don't cut your hand. Again check for perpendicularity. Removing the sharp corner, that operation is known as chamfering. Now these are the anvils and these are the MS rivet. Now the next operation is riveting operation. So these are the MS rivet. So in this we will see how to do riveting. These are the MS rivet. So first of all, rest the rivet on the anvil. These are the different shapes of anvil, right? So first rest the rivet on the anvil. Then first take the impression of the rivet on the job so that you will get the exact location where the rivet will be punched, where the rivet will be punched, right? So again take the impression. Now the location is fixed. Now you can make a riveting, right? You can make this riveting now with the help of this hammer. Blow the similar way the second rivet. First take the impression on the job. Let's say now this is the location of the rivet is fixed. At this position riveting will be there, and make it permanent joint by hammering the rivet. Now these two are the permanent joint. If you want to remove it, you have to break it. Similar way, the next two side, this two side will be joined by using spot welding. So these are the rivets. Now these two next two side will be joined using spot welding. So this is the spot welding machine. Since many of the students are nowadays are at home, you don't have the access of this spot welding machine. So better you will make all the four joint as a riveting joint, as a rivet joint. You can make all the four joint rivet joints. Okay, so these are the spot welding. And this is our final object. So you have to make this object at your home. whatever the resources you have available with you, use those resources and try to make this object at your home. So again, thank you KP Katara sir for your help.